Thursday, 14 April 2011. We are broadcasting live direct from the campus of Washington State University, Vancouver. This is the 8th annual Research Showcase featured here in the Furstenberg Student Union. We've got a room full of research projects, all kinds of really great activities going on, but especially this live streaming broadcast all over the World Wide Web, courtesy of two students in the Creative Media and Digital Culture Program, Mikhail Oberon and Dale Strauss. This is all part of their project for the senior seminar class, DTC 476, Digital Literacy Senior Seminar. They're working on a project called Vancouver Arts Live. And speaking of live, it's my pleasure to tell you that coming up next on this live interweb streaming broadcast, we have music from an incredible local musician, Adam Dvorak. He's here. He's ready to go. He's got some great music lined up, one of which is his current hit release all over the known universe, Stand Up, Scream Out. So the next person you see and hear will be Adam Dvorak. Thanks so much for being here. Stay tuned. There's more cool stuff coming up throughout the day, and someone will be talking with you. So take care, and Adam is up next. Thank you.
CNBC program. Mikhail Operin and I are broadcasting live. And next up, we have Alex Kleestra to play some music for you on his violin. So here he is. Thank you.
John Barber once again from the Creative Media and Digital Culture Program at Washington State University, Vancouver. We are broadcasting live and direct without benefit of commercial interruption from the Furstenberg Student Center, where the 8th annual research showcase is now ongoing. Remind me of your last name again.
McDowell.
With me is Carly McDowell, who is the executive director of the Vancouver Symphony Orchestra. It's one of the projects that Mikhail Operin and Dale Strauss is including in their Vancouver Arts Live Broadcaster project, which is bringing you this live streaming program that you're seeing right now. So, Carly, tell me about the Vancouver Symphony Orchestra. What is it? There's probably people that don't know about it.
Absolutely. The Vancouver Symphony Orchestra is a 32-year-old organization. We're a nonprofit community symphony orchestra in Vancouver, Washington, not Vancouver, British Columbia.
Vancouver, USA.
Yes, the only place to be. And we have a world-renowned maestro, Salvador Brotons, who hails from Barcelona. And he is with us during every concert week of the year. We have a multi-concert season. And right now we're wrapping up this year, our 32nd season, and Salvador's 20th anniversary with us. And we have a 65-member orchestra of highly talented musicians from our community, many of whom are teachers of our own children in our school district. And do private lessons as well, and come from a number of neighborhoods and businesses in the Vancouver and Greater Portland, Oregon area.
Excellent. So you have concerts coming up.
We do.
Still, right?
We do.
When
we do.
And what?
When
give
and
us
what?
A scooby.
May 14th and 15th is the last concert of our season, John, and then we will spend the summer getting ready to launch a brand new arts and music consortium called Music Live for next season, and next year we will have 5 of our regular classic symphony concerts, as well as launching a chamber music series that will move around town. We're also planning to have a music festival in the summer of 2012. This is all new stuff, a lecture series provided by the Friends of the Symphony, as well as a literacy project that will link our community, our schools, our library, and all of us to the performance of Candide by the orchestra in April of next year. So we just have a busy year ahead of us. We are the best show in town. We've been told by many of our guests that we rival the I won't give their name, but another local symphony. We have free parking and the lowest tickets for a high class symphony experience.
So now you've got us all hot to come to the symphony concerts. Where are they held? You didn't tell us that.
That's a great question. Our symphonies are held at Skyview High School Concert Hall, which is an all bells and whistles performing arts center in Vancouver, Washington, USA. And we have free parking there too, and it's a very intimate experience. It's an 800 to 900 seat auditorium, and it's a fabulous place to go and just relax. Our concerts are on Saturdays and Sundays, 5 to 6 times a year.
So I know from my experience, that's a Saturday in the afternoon and Sunday in the evening, right?
That's exactly right. Saturday afternoons at 3 to 5 p.m. and Sunday evenings from 7 to 9 p.m. And you can get tickets on our website, which is VancouverSymphony.org. www. Make sure you put that in so you don't go to British Columbia. VancouverSymphony.org. You can also call and order tickets over the phone at 360-735-7278.
Excellent. And what final culminating comment would you make about the Vancouver Symphony?
I would love to make a culminating comment. Our symphony supports youth and education outreach every year, and we just wrapped up our 17th Young Artist Competition, which heralds children from ages about 12 to 20 from all around our area. And it's a fabulous showcase of just amazing, amazing talent. And we really love to get behind that and also to provide free in-school concerts every year when the maestro's in town in May. So this year, on May 13th, we'll be presenting to the school districts as part of our mission, the in-school concerts for elementary school children.
Excellent. Well, thank you so much. And thank you also for your support of Mikhail and
Mikhail and Dale have been awesome and have brought a lot of support to the symphony. And because of all of their talents and this project, we're hoping to see all of you at our May concert.
Excellent. Well,
thanks,
thank you.
John.
Thanks for being here. Thanks out there in internet
Dale.
TV land. Again, we're at the 8th Annual Research Showcase. We've got a live musical performance coming up next, so don't leave your screen. It's going to be quite cool.
Talk about her project for a senior seminar.
All right.
Take it away.
My my project, the senior seminar, is called Stimulating Technology for Educational Motivation. It's a collaboration between the MESA program, which is Math, Engineering, Science Achievement, and the MOVE Lab, which is a motion-operated tracking virtual environment. And what the goal of the project is to bring middle school students into the environment and really learn about how the technology works, and also to learn in the environment. It consists of two different parts. The first one is the MOVE Lab tutorial. And in the MOVE Lab tutorial, what students will be doing is they'll start off with an introduction, and they'll be moving throughout the space and interacting with the different walls and learning about what is involved in the technology and how the technology works. Then they'll move into a section where they're actually going to learn to program and basically learn how to create an object within the MOVE Lab. And then after that, they're going to move on to a troubleshooting section. And in that section, what they're going to be doing is learning about current issues within the technology of the MOVE Lab. The second part of the project is Math Movers, and this is to get students engaged and having fun. Science, technology, engineering, and math fields are typically not viewed as fun or interesting by students. It's not that they're bad subjects, it's just how they're taught isn't quite understandable by the students. So the basic goal of Math Movers is to really get students involved in the learning process and to get them moving. Students these days, they know technology, they're digital natives. So they can interpret the environment and also have fun at the same time. We're really seeking just to give the students a learning experience that gets them moving and gets them stimulated in every way and just encourages them in the learning process.
So how exactly does it become fun for students in the MOVE Lab like that?
Well, basically, the fun comes from engaging in the environment. They're being stimulated visually. There's going to be sound effects. So their eyes, their ears, their body, every part of them is going to be interacting with the environment. So they're going to be immersed, and they're going to be learning.
And I'm standing here with Stephanie and Joe from the CMDC program, and they're going to tell us about their senior seminar project. Take it away.
Alrighty.
We made a social media environment called College Town that will help students stay on track to graduate, hopefully. And they'll get awarded the badges that are awarded by the faculty, and so it'll help you complete the levels. And those badges are searchable, so you can help find mentors that have the qualities you need.
So they can go through, and then they can be a mentor to the people who are coming up. That's
right. So
great.
If you need help with photography, you can click on the photography badge and search for photographers, and you'll get a list of people that can help you.
So have you gotten any, like, new people to go through the system and use a mentor yet?
Not yet.
But once it's online, designing it, right?
Yes.
Over the summer, they're going to make the website at the next senior class, and then it'll go live for testing.
So will it be hosted here at WSU, the website?
Yes.
And then once the CMDC program is through testing it, then it can be expanded to other degrees and the whole school.
So, like, if somebody's taken a digital media class, a digital imaging class,
right,
and they don't know Photoshop, they can go on there and find a Photoshop person.
That's great.
And then he's going to expand with the forum. So you can post questions and post tutorials and projects. So, like,
examples.
So you can see. Yeah.
So basically, somebody could be sitting at their house with a, I've got this terrible Photoshop problem, I can't figure out how to do it, and they can just get online and on the forum and ask a question, and someone
can give hints on, you know, what tool to use to make it easier.
Yeah.
That's great. Wow. And it's free.
It's free.
It is free.
It's unlike lynda.com or some other forum you might have to join for a fee. It's free.
That's right.
Once again, with Brady Birkmeister?
Birkenmeyer.
And Brett Overgaard, both from the CMDC program. They're going to tell us about their project with Fort Vancouver. Take it away, guys.
So, well, we're doing a mobile
application for the Fort Vancouver Historical Site. So you'll be able to go to the site, download it onto your phone, and then interact with the site a number of different ways. We're using geolocation technology to create these what we call hotspots, and every time that your phone enters one of those, it'll react in a different way, play a different form of multimedia, and create a more interactive experience at the historical site. So,
yeah, we're looking at new ways to interpret history through technology, giving access to people who wouldn't necessarily be interested in or want to explore a historic site, and to find the ways that engage with them on different levels than the traditional media. We're also trying to appeal to children. So one of the things we're doing, Brady is working on some animated content to have the history of Fort Vancouver in a cartoon form.
That's right, yeah. With the Paul Kane module, which I'm actually displaying here today, we're going to walk through the footsteps of the artist Paul Kane, who came to the fort about 150 years ago to document the people and the places. He did sketches of portraits and landscapes and interviews with people. So we're actually going to ask people to walk, or actually users, to walk through his footsteps and actually snap pictures in places where he's done landscapes. As Brett mentioned, we'll actually try to bring his artwork to life through digital animation to get the younger demographics.
A really important part about this is it's not just like you're sitting there watching TV. It's not a passive experience. You'll be integrated with the site in the physical ways, integrated with the digital content, interacting with the site physically and through your mobile device. So there's a whole range of experience that you can have in this process.
So yeah, I think that's about it. Yeah, but very exciting project. And yeah, we're happy to be here. So
Come visit FortVancouverMobile.net to find out more about us. If you want to schedule a tour or to use the application, just send us an email through there. Thank you for spending your time. It could be another second.
Thank you.